Fabiola Limardo, and I want to thank Dr. Patricia Valerio and Vanya Cecilbeck for inviting me to present my topic here today. And it's a pleasure to be in this amazing Congress. Thank you very much. I'll speak about breathing, and I speak from the spiritual science called anthroposophy that gives us a vision of the topic from a spiritual state of mind. So now we will see what is anthroposophic dentistry. And it's an extension of conventional dentistry, which works from a full understanding of the human being, including its physical, soulish, and spiritual dimension. It was created by the scientists and philosopher Rudolf Steiner and Rita Bergman in 1920. And the therapy included some multi-professional work oriented by the anthroposophy. So, from this vision, we will see that the mouth is the mirror of the human being in its whole, and the language of teeth is an universal alphabet that allows to understand the psychoaffective of the human being. Now we will introduce some basic concepts to understand more what I will speak about the subject. So we will speak about human threefold system, and we will see that from the idea of the human being constituted by body, soul, and individuality, we can find in them the same ternary organization. The body has a pole centered in the head that it calls sensory neural system, a pole centered on the abdomen and limbs that calls metabolic system, and a system of balance which equilibrates them called rhythmic system. And this is the base of the health. The human soul can be divided into three areas: thought, feeling, and will. And the spirit has three aspects: awareness, semi-conscious, and unconscious. The three systems are reflected on the face. The forehead corresponds to the nervous system, the eyes, nose, and cheeks to the circulatory system, and the part of the mouth and chin to the digestive system. And finally, we find this idea again in arcades, in the mouth region. The superior jaw and the lips belong to the sensorial system. The inferior jaw and the lips belong to the metabolic system, and the occlusion zone and the tongue to the rhythmic system, that is the feeling sphere. So we can see that we can understand more the diseases becomes clear when we consider the diseases as a manifestation of the hyperactivity or hypoactivity of one of the two polar systems. Yes, and in the balance is the health. So we will see more deeper how we can go deeper in these concepts in the oral structures. Now, with the mouth is the first segment of the digestive system, embryologically endodermal, linked to the unconscious. Is the place with the individual makes contact, test, ingest the world or not, and through it we communicate with the world around us. We can say that the mouth is a threshold, an edge. We can relate on the teeth with the process of thinking, the tongue with the sensorial perception organs, the lips. Sensibility has relation with the feelings, and the palate is relation with our metabolism and will. The teeth has relation with, we can see from the image of the teeth, correlation between the individual system as a microcosmos and the universal system as the macrocosmos. So this allows to understand also the psychoaffective of the human being. The tongue represents the psychic, the emotional. Controlling the tongue means self-control. Dropping tongue gives way to the whole body. When the tongue is in its place, gives light and lightness, and activates an energy center and physiologically the trigeminal nerve. The tongue is an essential organ for the maturation of the brain and the formation of thoughts. The lips express an exteriorization of the intimates, which in turn close the door to form an interior space. As the lips develop as organ of speech, they become expressions of self-control. We can see in the palate that is the stone of swallowing, and here consciousness is asleep. We can control the swallow reflex, and after swallowing, what happened, we forgot it. It is the last step to know if the incorporated substance is suitable for the body, and there the body only accepts or rejects the substance. The nose as a median organ of the face is a kind of reproduction of the rhythmic organism and the feelings of the soul. The lower portion of the nose informs about lung life. Yes, now we saw some concept about oral structures. We will see oral functions that we will always consider that the functions gives the shape to the organ. We know about the relations about the mouth and the organs, and we consider as dentists the neurovegetative functions. But we can include also the psychoaffective side. We can know about the psychoaffective side generates the thinking and describe the function, and finally we see the shapes of the organs. So we will speak a little bit more of these relations from the breathing. Breathing is considered as the provider of oxygen of the body and remover of carbonic acid. Carbonic acid, entonces, it's the first of the vital processes. It is the basic precondition for the life of man. But the physiological process is only a mere aspect of this happening. We see in the breathing that the souls enter the body in inhalation and is shared with the world in exhalation. In each inhalation, the spirit and soul are connected with the body, and in each exhalation, they come off. Vigil and sleep, birth and death are the older brother of this respiratory rhythm. And we can see the breathing, the relation between breathing and environment. Breathing is one of the most important relationships of man with the environment. The man breathes with the environment. Each inspiration is a subtle intake of sensory impressions in our body. We take cosmic forces around us, we train and renew. With the first breath, inner emotional life begins. The soul life enters into a deeper relationship with the body. The small lung begins to develop, and an independent process of the mother begins. About inhalation and exhalation, we can observe that each human being has different breathing habits, which correspond to their constitution. The more inhaling person is being driven by the neurosensory system, and the more exhaling by the metabolic motor system. This is very important in our diagnosis also. In about breathing and awareness, we see that our states of consciousness are directly related to the respiratory processes. The carbon element is related to being awake or in excess its lethal effect. Too much inhalation means restriction. Neurosensory expressions cannot be digested. The consequence is very being very awake. When the exhalation is very long, the person is numb. So too much and too little awareness can accompany these unilateralities. And about breathing and mood, we see that breathing reveals the state of mind of the individual. The soul experiences affect the body as a stimulus, just a stimulus or inhibition. On the contrary, the body disorders disturb and modify our state of mind. The correlation body, soul, and its load correspond to the dynamic of the air. And about heritage and breathing, we see that in the first years of life, organic forms are configured and are influenced by the respiratory processes. These are produced by the experience of the environment and the imitation of adults. The mood and the individuality plays an essential role within existing influences. In relation of, with the skeleton structure, we see that the process of breathing can be observed in connection to the skeleton structuring. The shape of skeleton is determined by movements whose tone is in turn modeled by the breathing. The way in which the person resonates configuratively through the body depends on the relationship with the brain, the breath. And about the language, when the body and soul are in the right point of tension and tonicity, our breathing is in perfect harmony. We feel good and our language sounds healthy. Excessive tensions lead to stiffness and lack of tension to loss of form and vitality. An imbalance in breathing can be heard in the dynamic of speech and posture. And there is a relation between paranasal sinuses and thinking. They develop during the first year of life. Functionally, they are essential for the healthy functioning of the senses, such as smell and hearing, and for the nervous system in its function for thinking. Free air in the cranium is important for healthy mental activity. And active sinusitis will significantly hinder the ability to think. And about rhythms, we know that the man also breathes in the field of vital functions, in stomach, intestine, peristalsis, etc. When the child is born, it is very arrhythmic. The rhythm will be learned little by little. The rhythms of the cosmos are included in the body and become body rhythms. And finally, between breathing and attentions, we can see that the perceptions depends on breathing from the neurological point of view. Children who breathe harmoniously can alternate play and concentration. When they have a short breath, they can pay enough attention. And breathing relation, of course, with the human figure. In the human figure, it appears condensed the image of the being. The strength to stand up is the ability to handle heaviness and lightness. Only the upright posture produces separation between the individual and the world, and the subsequent acquisition of speech and touch. So, from this vision of in the normal aspects, from the spiritual vision. Now we will study more about mouth breathing. We know that mouth breathing is not more than a sign of a general syndrome, that is breathing insufficiency. Mouth breathing is not a natural path. It is a shortcut for survival, which implies a series of adaptation of the organism that visibly alters its posture, leading to physical psychoaffective consequences. We'll see some signs that integrate the mouth breathing syndrome from a spiritual perspective. We know, we remember that oral breathing with oral breathing, we have alterations in the general health, psychoemotional and behavioral alterations, aesthetic and functional, and postural. About facial alteration, we have adenoid fasces, thin and elongated face, paleness and presence of dark circles, thin cheekbones, narrow nose, hypotonic lips, thin vertebrae, and absence of lip closure. And buccal alterations, upper jaws compression with Viag's ogival palate, jaw reduction, protruding upper incisors, class 2 malocclusion, and low tongue and atypical swallowing. And postural alterations, we have anterior position of the head, rectification of the cervical spine, rotation of both shoulders, forward, lumbar lordosis, legs in necks, and flat feet. And finally, hypotonic musculature. Well, now we will see this diagnosis from this all we have seen until now and relation these signs that integrate the mouth breathing from this spiritual perspective. About the mouth breathing and the environment, we see that he has a difficult relationship with his breathing. This will affect his exchange with the environment. The inhalation processes predominate in him. He does not exhale correctly. This reflects aspect of his psychic activity. We have effects in the neurosensory system, poor oxygenation, sleepy conscience. This often affects school performances. We have alterations in rhythms, breathing, these digestion processes, dream, wakefulness, etc. Sleep is affected, is choppy, restless, has nightmares, he feels tired and with low vitality. From the metabolism is weakened, digestion is incomplete, chewing and peristaltic laziness and little gastric secretion. They eat very quickly without chewing, swallowing with the help of liquids. They do not like hard foods. Sometimes they give up eating and become very thin. From the psycho-emotional disturbances, we see that the mouth breathing is generally distracted, restless, agitated, and impatient, present hyperactivity, and he's not interested in sports. He sometimes doesn't respect limits. The heart means suffocation, reset, and any approach. It usually presents visual and hearing problems. From a facial diagnosis, the lungs have a tendency upon the organs in him, and the whole organism tends to be dominated by the air principle. The face pale and an absence of vital energy. This reflects the difficulty of the individuality to dominate his body. The long face also shows the influence of the forces of gravity that attracts him to the ground. And from a facial diagnosis, we see as the superior third that the broad is forehead indicates a predominance of the forces of the nervous system. The middle third, we see nose narrow, thin, and elongated. It shows an introverted character. And in the lower third, we see the superior jawbone in protrusion and jaw protrusion. This reflects strength of the neurosensitive forces and very weak will. From an oral diagnosis, we see that the lips are hypotonic, reddish, and edematose. And the upper incisor teeth is forward and shows weakness in upright forces. The mouth is the border between individuality and its environment. When it remains open, the person is not able to control the quality of his experiences. It will give the impression that it is not firmly seated with this personality in his body. From the tongue, we see that it is motionless and down, and in the mouth breather. And that also shows a vague will with lack of enthusiasm and a vague disposition to its motions. The taste of perception also is difficult. And we see difficulty also in the production of phonemes related to a typical swallowing. And from an oral diagnosis, we see that the saliva is acid and thick, which led to the production of caries, and the arcades are compressed in a V shape. The middle line may be deviated. This is very important from the diagnosis of the personality, yes, the symmetry. And from the posture attitude, the mouth breather, we see that they suffer from the earthly gravity of his body. He cannot dominate his physical body well. He doesn't know how to use it as an instrument. He's always with the head down and his back bent down, and if he were attracted by the ground, the inner forces cannot develop freely. So, what will be the therapy? We can consider dysmorphosis as the difficulty that an individual feels toward his form. The therapeutic act is to allow the patient to adjust internally to his body shape to what he is. The functional orthopedics of the show creates new neurological pathways, causing a chain reaction in the current functions, body posture, walking, behavior, etc. It is a new awakening of the organism. In orthopedics, we also need an implantation of the rhythm, the discipline, and the constancy. This is very important to the child. And we can say that the mechanic therapy is a therapy of the will. Here we have some pictures, initial and photos, and final photos of the functional orthopedic treatment. We work and from the interdisciplinary team. So now we say that the structure of the mouth reflects the psychoaffective aspect and its functional disorders. If we don't intervene, the structure continues nurturing the type of the psychoaffective situation associated with it. This is a true vicious cycle. That is why it is necessary to work both on the affective plane and on the level of the structure of the mouth. From the anthroposophic therapies, we work at the level of the individuality and the psychic field and the body. From the level of individuality, the doctor, dentist, or psychologist seek to awaken awareness of the main meaning of the disease in the patient's biography. In the psychic field, we work with psychology, curative pedagogy, and art therapy. The body is cared through medications, nutrition, rhythmic message, healing arrhythmic, chirophonetics, anthroposophic pharmacy, and canto therapy. So, our conclusion is that anthroposophy offers a spiritual counterpart to a dental practice that is increasingly oriented towards technology. It insists on the fact that the first therapeutic act is the human presence. It allows to understand that the mechanical devices used in the functional orthopedics deploy forces whose effects exceed the physical body. It emphasizes the importance of an integral diagnosis that includes the physical, mental, and spiritual aspects, and lets us project a therapy that embraces all these spheres. then the dentomaxillary harmony will be a reflex that the deep spheres of the patient have returned from to a necessary balance to lead a healthy biopsychic life. Thank you very much.